Hello everyone, welcome to Flamingo. Today we are with the fifth chapter, that is indigo, right? Now you all know indigo is a dye sort of thing, okay? And this chapter what we are going to talk about, here we have a famous person, you know, Gandhiji, and here the writer Louis Fisher is undergoing an interview with Gandhiji, and the whole chapter is regarding that. The is based on the interview where Gandhiji is sharing his experience in Champaran and how he tried to help the sharecroppers from the hands of the British. Let's see. Indigo, about the author, we'll see. Louis Fisher was born in Philadelphia. He served as a volunteer in the British Army between 1918 and 1920. That's given in the introduction. Okay. Fisher made a career as a journalist and wrote for the New York Times. He was a journalist and he had come to interview whom? Gandhiji in his ashram, Sevagram. The Saturday Review and for European and Asian publications. These are all his publications. He was also a member of the faculty at Princeton University. The following is an excerpt from this book, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. He's taken a piece from there. The book has been reviewed as one of the best books ever written on Gandhiji by Times Educational Supplement. So this is the introduction, and as I told you, it's an interview which Fisher had come to take with Gandhiji. When I first visited Gandhiji in 1942, this is who is saying, the journalist, who is the Louis Fisher is saying that when he first for the first time when he met Gandhiji, when in the year 1942, okay, where in his ashram, whose ashram? Gandhiji's ashram, and that was in Sevagram in central India. He said, I'll tell you how it happened that I decided to urge the departure of the British, and it was in 1917. When the interview started, what did Gandhiji say? That he was in the interview, he'll describe how he was urged, means determined, how he since long he been determined that he would quit the British from our country, and since then he been trying that, and how things went on. He had gone to the December 1916 annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party in Lucknow. Who? Gandhiji had gone for a convention, means for a meeting, where at Lucknow. And the meeting was with whom? The different delegates were there. And the meeting was between this Indian National Congress Party and the others. They were 2301 delegates were there, and so many other visitors were also there. As the proceedings were going on, Gandhiji recounted, a patient came up to me. Gandhiji is giving the interview. In between, he said that as these proceedings for the meetings and things were going on, one of the patient is a farmer, came in between, and then he was looking very poor and emaciated. Emaciated means very lean, feeble, weak sort of a person. And he came and said what to Gandhiji? I am Rajkumar Shukla. Okay, I am from Champaran and I want you to come to my district. As Gandhiji was busy with the meeting in Lucknow on the Indian National Congress Party he was representing. That time who came? This Rajkumar Shukla came, and what did he want? He wanted that Gandhiji should accompany him to Champaran and help out with the condition that was prevailing then with this patients in Champaran. And I want you to come to my district. Gandhi had never heard of the place. Which place? Champaran. It was in the foothills of the towering Himalayas near the kingdom of Nepal. Under an ancient arrangement, the Champaran patients were sharecroppers. Ancient means old arrangement, understanding was there, or a share these people, the Britishers and the Indian patients, they had a managed to work with two understanding between the two, and there were terms and conditions. And what was it? that Rajkumar Shukla temporary patient special. It was that the Britishers forced these Indian patients to work in the fields. In their fields, they were compelled to grow 15% of their land. They should grow what? They should grow indigo, and then that should be after the harvesting. That should be given as a rent to the Britishers. It was the ancient arrangement. And Shukla was one of the patients who has to work accordingly. He was illiterate but resolute, very determined, stern person, even though he was not educated. He had come to the Congress session, this meeting which was going on, to complain about the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar, and somebody had probably said, speak to Gandhi. Rajkumar Shukla, he himself was suffering, and then someone had told him that this problem, if he goes to Gandhiji or talk to Gandhiji about this problem, then might be the problem can be solved. So he had come there to solve the problem. The same condition was going on, and injustice was being done to the land system that was undergoing in Bihar with the peasants, to the peasants. Gandhi told Shukla he had an appointment in Kanpur and was also committed to go to other parts of India. When Rajkumar Shukla told him that he should accompany him to Champaran and also help the patients in Bihar, so Gandhiji was helpless and he said he couldn't come because he had to go to Kanpur and also some other appointments he has to go in different parts of India. Shukla accompanied him, but Shukla did not step back. He went wherever Gandhiji went, and then he returned. When Gandhiji returned back to his ashram in Ahmedabad, then Shukla again went with him to the ashram. For weeks he stayed with Gandhiji, and then he requested Gandhiji, fix some date and come with me. Impressed by the sharecropper's tenacity and story, Gandhi said, I have to be in Calcutta on such and such date. Come and meet me and take me from there. So with sharecropper means seeing, we saw that so determined Rajkumar Shukla was. So Gandhiji told what? Tenacity means the behavior, the way Rajkumar Shukla behaved with him and all. So Gandhiji was very impressed by his behavior and determination. So he said that he was to go to Calcutta, and from there he can take him to wherever he wants. Months passed. Shukla was sitting on his haunches at the appointed spot in Calcutta when Gandhiji arrived. Okay, so since months, Rajkumar Shukla waited there in Calcutta. Haunches means just bent the knees, and they were sitting on his, not all those on the floor, but just with the legs folded. He kept sat there and was waiting for Gandhiji to come. Then the two of them boarded a train from the city of Patna in Bihar. There Shukla had led him to the house of a lawyer named Rajendra Prasad. Okay, so Gandhiji agreed from Calcutta. Both of them, Shukla and Gandhiji, went by train to Bihar, and there Mr. Shukla took Gandhiji where? To a lawyer's house whose name was Rajendra Prasad. And this Rajendra Prasad, later on, he was the president of the Congress party, and after that became the president of India also. Rajendra Prasad was, when they went there, they could not get Rajendra Prasad because he was out of the town. But the servants were there, and the servants knew Shukla, Rajkumar Shukla, because he was he had been there time and again, and he was a poor yeoman. Yeoman means what? They knew that he was a small farmer and who had always come to Rajendra Prasad for help. Okay, and their master to help indigo sharecroppers. Often he had pestered means time and again Rajkumar Shukla had come to Rajendra Prasad for help, requesting to help these indigo sharecroppers. So they let him stay on the ground, means on, because they knew him, he allowed Rajkumar Shukla. But the Gandhiji, they did not allow him because they were not knowing who Gandhiji is, and their owner was also not there, so they did not allow. And Gandhiji wanted to draw some water from the well, that also they did not allow, because in those days untouchability and things were always at the peak, and they thought Gandhiji, because he was accompanying Rajkumar Shukla, so he thought Gandhiji also might be of the same, and so they What did they do? They did not permit to draw water from the well, lest small drops from this bucket pollute the entire source. Means any, they did not allow Gandhiji to take water from the well, provided the drops would fall and the whole area, because Gandhiji they thought might be an untouchable person and the water would be polluted. So they did not allow. Gandhiji decided to go first to Muzaffarpur, which was en route to Champaran, to obtain more complete information about the conditions. That they did not get Rajendra Prasad, so they did not wait there, but they continued to go further, and then first to Muzaffarpur, and on their way they would decided to go to Champaran to have a complete information about the things, whatever the condition was. He accordingly sent a telegram, and by on the other end, Gandhiji sent a telegram to whom? To Professor J.B. Kriplani. And who was he? He was the teacher or the professor over in the Arts College in Muzaffarpur, whom he had seen at Tagore's Shantiniketan. And how did Gandhiji know him? Gandhiji and this J.B. Kriplani met each other in Rabindranath Tagore's Shantiniketan, a very famous place in Calcutta. The train arrived at midnight. They were on the train. And what was the date? It was 15th April 1917. That was the date. Kriplani was waiting. When they reached there, Kriplani was waiting there at the railway station, and others was the teacher in the school. So, but he was named as Professor Kriplani. So, he had accompanied so many students, and they were waiting for Gandhiji to reach there. It was an extraordinary thing in those days. Gandhi commented for a government professor to harbor a man like me. He's saying that in those days, Gandhiji was telling all these things to whom? Because interview is going on. So Gandhiji was telling to Fisher that those days to go with the professor, and then huge group of students and all, people supporting them and all these things. It was really a big thing. And he's saying a person like me means he was the one who had protested against the British rule and so on. He wanted the Britishers to move away from our country. And those days, no one would dare even to speak to the Britishers or take the initiative. So, if the whole this professor and the whole group of students were walking, so that was really a daring thing. It was an extraordinary thing. In small localities, the Indians were afraid to show sympathy for advocates of home rule. Advocates means people who are supporting home rule, means they want their country to be back, or who are against the Britishers' rule. Those days, if anyone helps also them, then it was really a offense, and people were afraid to even show their sympathy to others. The news of Gandhiji's advent and the nature of his mission spread quickly through Muzaffarpur and to Champaran sharecroppers. From Champaran began arriving on foot and by conveyance to see their champion. And then the news that Gandhiji has come to Champaran, the news spread everywhere in Muzaffarpur as well as Champaran. And as soon as the news spread, what happened? The whole lot of these sharecroppers, okay, were rushed on foot, on other modes of transport and all, and they rushed to see the champion. Who is the champion? Gandhiji. Muzaffarpur lawyers called on Gandhiji to brief him. They frequently represented patient groups in the court. They told him about their cases, and very soon the lawyers, as it is he had told, so the lawyers came and briefed Gandhiji what is the situation going on in Muzaffarpur. Gandhiji chided the lawyers for collecting big fees from the sharecroppers. While briefing, the sharecroppers told Gandhiji also that so and so is the fees they are taking from these patients. So Gandhiji got very angry, and he scolded. Chided means scolded them, that the sharecroppers, as it is, they are very needy, and they are not so rich to give the fees and things. Then why do you ask fees from these poor people? He said, I have come to the conclusion that we should stop going to law courts. Taking such cases to the courts does little good. And Gandhiji said that now these things they will solve on their own, instead of going to the law courts and things, because hardly things come to a solution in the law courts. where the patients are so crushed and fear stricken, law courts are useless. He says that people do not dare to go there, and then how would they express or tell their problems? So it's better not to go. And as it is, these courts are never helpful to these sharecroppers. The real relief is to them is to be free from fear. So first of all, these people, the sharecroppers who have that fear of facing the situation, that should be lessened instead of going to the court. Rather, they should be initiative, or they should be boosted that they get rid or get the fear. They could lessen the fear. Most of the arable land in Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and worked by Indian tenants. What is that? Arable means in Champaran, most of the cultivated land was what? Divided by in big estates. Okay, and who was the owner? These Englishmen are the owners, and the who worked there? These Indian farmers worked there. The chief commercial crop was indigo. And what crop they have to grow there? That is indigo. The landlords compelled. Who are these landlords? The British men compelled, forced these tenants or farmers to plant 320 acres for 15% of their holdings. As I told you initially, that 15% of the land, the tenants or farmers in Champaran were forced to grow what? Indigo. And then that should, after the harvesting, that should be given as what? As a rent to these English people. And this was done by long-term contract. Presently, the landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo, and they thereupon obtained agreements from the sharecroppers to pay them compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. And then they came to know, these farmers in Champaran, that in Germany synthetic indigo has gone. So many people on their own, instead of growing this indigo, they tried to make agreements with whom? The sharecroppers, that compensation for being released, they should be released from this 15% arrangement. Sharecropping arrangement was irksome. Irksome means not comfortable, and to the patients. And so many of them willingly signed that without doing, you take the 15%. Those who resisted, those who for that they will not give, then they engaged lawyers, and then these landlords, what did they do? These Englishmen, if anyone resisted or denied not to grow the indigo, then these landlords kept thugs, means gundas and gunda sort of people that they kept, and they hired these gundas, and they would force whom? For thugs, what we call in simple Hindi. Okay, and then they would force these patients to grow the indigo. Meanwhile, the information about synthetic indigo reached the illiterate patients who had signed, and they wanted their money back. At this point, Gandhiji arrived in Champaran. Gandhiji now has reached Champaran. He began by trying to get the facts first. He visited the secretary of the British Landlords Association. He came there to bring a solution. After reaching Champaran, what did Gandhiji do? Gandhiji first met whom? The secretary of the British Landlords Association. But as he met the secretary, what did he do? He said that he cannot give any information to an outsider. He did not know Gandhiji, so considered him as an outsider and did not disclose the secret of their workings. Gandhiji answered that he was no outsider. In reply, what did Gandhiji say? That he was not an outsider. It is his country. Next, Gandhiji, when he did not get any attention from the secretary, where did he go? He went to the British official commissioner of Tirhut division, and in which the Champaran district lay. The commissioner, Gandhi reports, proceeded to bully me and advised me forthwith to leave Tirhut. And as he, after the secretary, Gandhiji went to whom? The commissioner. And the commissioner was also an Englishman. So he, what did he do? He bullied me. Means he started laughing at Gandhiji or making fun of Gandhiji. That what have you come here for? You will not come to a solution. It is better you leave Tirhut. Gandhiji, but was very stern, we are told. He did not leave it. But what did he do? He moved towards Motihari, which was the capital of Champaran. so many lawyers he accompanied with, and then at the railway station a vast multitude greeted Gandhiji. Multitude, a big crowd met him. Then he went to a house and he made that house as an headquarters, and from there he started investigating the problems. A report came to him that a patient has been maltreated in a nearby village. While he was in that house, that is the headquarters, were in this Motihari, what message did he get? He got the message that a patient was very badly maltreated, means badly treated by the this Englishman in the nearby village. Gandhiji decided to go there, and next morning on the back, he sat on the back of an elephant and proceeded. And then while he was going, what happened? The police superintendent messenger overtook him, to ask him to go, and ordered him to return. While he was going, a police officer's messenger came to Gandhiji and asked him to go back. Gandhiji complied. He agreed to go with the messenger. And what did this messenger do? The messenger took Gandhiji home, and then who served him with an official notice. And after taking home, what did he do? He served him, means gave him a letter. And what was written in that? That he has to quit Champaran immediately. In the letter it was written that Gandhiji should immediately leave Champaran. Gandhiji signed the receipt and notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. Gandhiji also gave a reply in writing that he will not obey the order. In consequence, and because of this, what happened? Gandhiji was called, summoned means called to the court the very next day. Whole night Gandhiji remained awake. What did he do? He remained awake, and then he was deciding or thinking what to do the next day. So he telegraphed Rajendra Prasad and asked him to come from Bihar with some influential friends, means people who know or who know what to do in that situation. And at the same time, he sent some instructions to the ashram also. He wired a full report to the viceroy. Wired means send a telegram. The next morning, found the town of Motihari black with patients. Black means full of patients. Next day, while Gandhiji was going there, what did he see? The whole place, Motihari, was full of these farmers. They did not know Gandhiji's record in South Africa. These people did not know Gandhiji had been to South Africa or what he had done there. They had merely heard that a Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble. They did not know in details about Gandhiji. Only they knew, or they got the message that the person, that Mahatma who had come to help these poor peasants, sharecroppers, is in trouble. So they accumulated, all gathered in Motihari. And their spontaneous demonstration in thousands around the courthouse was the beginning of their liberation from fear of British. And that was the first time when these people, these peasants, protested because Gandhiji was in trouble, or one Gandhiji was called there. So this was the first time that they raised their voice against these Englishmen for their liberation. The officials at that time felt that they are powerless, means they cannot control the crowd, because they became very restless without Gandhiji's help. So they requested Gandhiji, and with Gandhiji's help they can regulate, means control the crowd. And they found Gandhiji very politely and in a friendly manner requested the people not to demonstrate anything. He was giving them concrete proof that their might, hitherto dreaded and unquestioned, could be challenged by the Indians. And that way, it was a proof. Might means strength. Okay, the hitherto till then dreaded, and this Gandhiji was by showing them, and by now as it is, the Englishmen also understood that this power and the way they were trying to crush the Indians and all, now it is over, and the Indians have shown their might means their strength, and they are no longer afraid of the Britishers. And those day that they can, if they think their things are they can, what is that, fight against, or they can challenge the Britishers. That the Britishers came to know that day. So here I finish I stop here, and I continue it in the next one. Thank you for watching the video.